What's happening, my principal of management students? How are you? So we are entering week number 3 out of 7 weeks. I wanted to give you the update video, let you know what's happening, how we're progressing through this class, give you an update on what to expect and all that good stuff. So let me start off with week number 2 and how that ended up. So week number 2 was interesting. We had the holidays, of course. We had Memorial Day. I think last week I put out a video and I said thank you to all of our service men and women and families who have sacrificed for us to have this wonderful life that we do. And then, of course, this week happened, and we're still dealing with the coronavirus. Unfortunate situations in our society have occurred, and you know, I know that we are living through some extremely trying times, and I do not play the political role or game. I believe in people. I don't believe in politics. I don't believe in systems. I believe in people. I believe in you, and you are going through a very difficult time as a society. You are going through a very difficult time as an individual with all that has been thrown at you, and you are currently a college student. So I acknowledge that there's a lot happening. I acknowledge that there's a lot of stuff happening, but that doesn't mean that we are going to slow down, and it doesn't mean that we are going to stop and give up and lay down. Knowledge is power. I'm a true convinced that knowledge is power, and the more you learn about things, the more understanding and compassion and empathy you have towards those around you. I will share with you that I am the first graduate in my family in college, and I'm proud of that. I'm proud to say that my children had no other expectation but to go to college, and every time we try to push the envelope further and further in regards to the accomplishments that we can do. My parents came here as immigrants to this country with nothing other than the clothes on their back and a dream to give us a better life than they had in their country. And guess what? They saw that fulfilled. My sister is a nurse. My sister's a police officer in the city of Chicago. I am, of course, a professor. I've been a pastor. I've had many positions in life, but I want to, you know, let you know that the decision that you made to come back to school to fight the ignorance in our lives and to become knowledgeable and to have a degree, that is power, not only for you, but for those that come behind you, your children, your grandchildren, your nephews, your nieces, and all of those people that look up to you. So please be encouraged that you, my friends, are making a difference in your environment, that the change that we all hope to see in other people starts in the change that we do amongst ourselves and to the people that surround us. So I encourage you to continue to fight this fight. Continue to go and put your best effort in this class and in every class that you take, and continue to educate yourself. So week 2, interesting enough, we talked about ethical perspectives and why we make the decisions that we do. It's no better timing than to see what's happening around us, and we question, and it's easy for us to look at other people and say, why are they doing that? And we don't understand, and that's because we don't understand what ethics means to everyone. Your ethical perspective might not be someone else's ethical perspective. Last week, I posed the question, is it ever okay to lie? And a lot of you said, yeah, there's sometimes it's okay to lie. And other of you said, it's not really a lie. Well, a lie is a lie. And as much as some people say, well, it's a little white lie, and it just depends. those are ethical decisions that you've made and perspectives that you have. So some utilitarians are going to say, it just depends on the greater good of it. You know, is it gonna be a good thing at the end, or is it going to be a bad thing? Like, it depends. And other people say, no. Of course, there's some people that have relativism ethics, which looks at the ethical behavior opinion based on the relativeness of the people, on the community. So we look at all these different ethical perspectives, and then we understand our ethical perspective and why we make the decisions that we make. And I encourage you, especially now in the times that we're living, to look at everyone else and ask yourself the question, why ethically do they think this is okay? And it might not make sense to you, and it doesn't make sense to me sometimes, but I try to understand them from an ethical perspective and why they make the decisions that people make. So that was a very interesting topic. I have to go back. I'm reading through everyone's stuff, so it's going to take me a little bit of catch up on grading the discussions. So please just hang tight there. This week, we are going to move into a more business topic and not so much of a, social topic. This is called a SWOT analysis. And after you read in chapter 5 what a SWOT analysis is, I want you to pick a company to analyze and to create your own SWOT analysis. So what I'm looking for, and remember that if you post a video of it, extra points. But what I'm looking for is for you to grab a company and break it down in a SWOT format and create an analysis. Either create a picture or show me a picture or do something that demonstrates that you are able to create a SWOT analysis. This is a very important part in business. It's done all the time. You will see it consistently in your manager's position that you get once you graduate. And it's a phenomenal, phenomenal tool in business. So I'm looking forward to that. All right, the next thing I want to talk about is what's happening in week 4. So week 4 is technically halfway through our semester. And week 4, you have no discussion, but you do have a midterm. So make sure you are studying up on your quiz questions. Some of those questions will pop up in your midterm. So make sure that you are looking at your quizzes carefully and understand what's on them so that the midterm won't be so difficult. Normally, I'm going to be honest with you here. Normally, the midterm is a timed test. It's usually 40 multiple choice questions, and I usually have a 40-minute timer. That being said, you guys are already stressed with so much going on in this world, and I understand that. And what I'm doing as I'm speaking to you here is I am literally removing the time limit from your test. That way, you don't have to worry about it being timed and just focus on knowing the information. So I just adjust that. I'm clicking the last click here. And your test is now no longer timed. It's one shot with no time limit. So the midterm next week has no time limit. You have one opportunity to do it, but you have all the time in the world to do it. So please make sure you use that appropriately. All right, guys, I think that covers it. I gave you my little soapbox speech about staying positive, staying encouraged, keep doing hard work, and be the people of change, be the people of, be the agents of change. And I encourage you, I know we can't go out there and make a difference for everyone, but you can make a difference for those that are around you. And you can fight for those that you love and that are around you and teaching each other to love one another. So guys, I encourage you to stay positive and stay fighting for the cause of bettering yourself and those that surround you. If you need me, just reach out to me. Let me know what I can do to help you. Take care.